Welcome back to another Hack the Box quick guide. This time it's Devil. And looking at the Nmap scan, we see FTP and HTTP. So if we look at FTP, we're able to log in with the anonymous login, username anonymous, password anonymous. And we see some files here that correspond to the files on the web server. So a basic test we can do here is just try to upload an HTML file and see if we can get that to execute. So that's exactly what I'll be doing on this step here with just adding an H1 tag, because it's pretty easily to visually confirm. So we'll use the put command to upload it to the server, and we'll just confirm that it's there. And once we do that, we'll actually browse to it, and we see it does in fact render. So the next question is, can we upload a shell, and will the server actually execute? Obviously this is an IIS server, as we saw earlier from the IIS files that were in there. And so basically we'll generate a ASPX reverse shell using MSF Venom, and we're uploading that to the server. And we'll start our listener with Netcat as well, so we can grab that connection. So now browsing to, let's see if it'll actually execute it and connect to our listener. And it does. So now we will look at, see who we are, and we only have access as a pretty limited level user here. So there's some privilege escalation that we need to do. And we can run a system info to get some basic information on this Windows box here. And if we scroll up to the top of this here, we can see that it's Windows 7 and it's unpatched. There's no hot fixes. If you saw that, I know I cut that part off, but if we scroll to the bottom, it'll say that there's no hot fixes applied. So we can look for this particular build of Windows 7 and see if there's any exploits available for it. Now, upon doing that, we see an exploit DB local privilege escalation. So this is exactly what we're looking for. And actually, if we take this number here, this EDB ID, we can actually use that to identify it in SearchSploit. Because anything in exploit DB will be in SearchSploit. That's basically the command line version of it. So if we can search for exactly that, we'll find the exploit that we're looking at. And it's just easier to copy it using this. We could have copied it from the website, but this is just the way I prefer to do it, with the dash M flag for mirror. And now I like to personally rename it to something like exploit.c. So you see me doing that here. Now, once we do this, we need to cross compile this, right? We need to compile this so that it's compatible with this Windows system. So we're going to use MingGW32 to do this. It's a 32-bit system. And if you don't have that, you can install it with the app repository. So upon running this command, we will see we generated an executable. Now, since we do have FTP, we can upload the binary via FTP as you see on screen here. So upon doing that, when we go back to our shell, we will be able to just go straight into where the files are served up. That's normally an inet pub and www root. And to visually confirm, we see that there, and we see our exploit there as well. So we can just run it like so. And who am I? You validated, we've now read the box.